Welcome to the chemistry crash course. Today we are going to discuss about certain questions. Okay, so let me go for the one by one. Here 1 AMU is equals to, that is one atomic mass unit value, or they have asked one atomic mass unit is equals to. So the choices are 1/12 mass of carbon 12 isotope, option B 1/12 mass of the carbon 16 isotope, and 1 gram of the hydrogen, and 1.66 into 10 to the power minus 24 gram. Okay, so the question is that we have to know the what is 1 AMU is equals to. Here if you are going to eliminate this option and this option, because we are going to take the carbon 12 as a standard reference, so 1/12 mass of the carbon 12 is the correct according to the given choices. But there is a one more option, D, which is the nearly 1 AMU value, but only the difference is here 10 to the power minus 24 must be there, but the 1 AMU value is 1.66054 into 10 to the power minus 24 gram, but here they have given that is minus 23, so this option you have to eliminate. So as these three are not equal, means the first option is correct, that is 1 AMU is equals to 1/12 mass of the carbon 12 isotope. Clear? Suppose if it is 1.6605 into 10 to the power minus 24, means this is the value of the 1 AMU, but they have given minus 23, so we have to eliminate that option. So let me explain second question. The mass of one atom of the iron is 55.8 AMU, its mass in gram. The question is that they have given the mass of one atom of the iron in terms of AMU, that is 55.8 AMU, its mass we have to calculate in terms of gram. So it is very simple, we know that 1 AMU is equals to 1.66 into 54 into 10 to the power minus 24 grams. Clear? So now I need to convert this 55.8 AMU in terms of gram. So 55.8 into 1.66054 into 10 to the power minus 24. Okay. So if you calculate this roughly, it will going to get 92.7 into 10 to the power minus 24, but they have made that digital, that is one point is backward, 9.27 into 10 to the power minus 23, because here they converted, this will be 92.7 in terms of, so if we converted that will be at around 9.27. So if you calculating this one, means you are going to get the answer as 9.27 into 10 to the power minus 23 gram. So keep in mind that 1 AMU is equals to 1.66 into 10 to the power minus 24 gram. So we need to convert 55.8 AMU, means you have to multiply 1 AMU value to that, and you are going to get 9.27 into 10 to the power minus 23 gram. Clear? So let us go for the one more question. The percentage of the calcium in calcium carbonate is, so this is the question on the percentage composition. Here you need to calculate the percentage of the calcium, that is percentage of the calcium in calcium carbonate. So in order to find out the percentage of calcium, so what is the formula? You have to take the mass of calcium, okay, that is divided by total mass of compound into 100, as it is percentage composition. So mass of the calcium is 40, mass of the calcium is 40. And then total mass of the compound, how it is calculated? For calcium, it will be 40 plus carbon 12 plus 3 oxygens are there, per oxygen 16, 48, so into 100. So if you add these values, you are going to get 100 itself, 40 divided by 100 into 100. So this and this get cancelled with each other, you are going to get 40%. So here the option is 40%. So the percentage of calcium in calcium carbonate is 40%. Similarly, if they asked for carbon, means you have to take 12 divided by, for carbon, 12 divided by 100 into 100. Okay. So like this, you have to calculate the percentage of the calcium in the given calcium carbonate compound. Okay. So the percentage of any element, if they asked, means you have to take the mass, atomic mass of that element divided by total mass of the whole compound into 100. So here the answer will be 40%. Next, two solutions of a substance mixed in the following way. It means the two solutions are mixed. 480 ml of the 1.5 first solution and 250 ml of the 1.2 molar second solution. It means here this is the first solution and its molarity is 1.5 m, and the volume is 480. Okay, and it is mixed with the second solution, that is the second solution which is having the molarity of 1.2 molar and the volume is 250 ml. So the question is that the molarity of the final mixture, the molarity of the final mixture. So how the final mixture is obtained? By mixing of the, see here, first solution, second solution, whenever they are mixing, we are getting the third solution. So we need to calculate the molarity of this third solution, and they have given the molarity and the volume of these two solutions. So we can write one formula here. I need to calculate the molarity of the third solution, okay, and we have the relations M3V3 is equals to, how the third solution is formed? By the combination of the first solution and by the combination of the second solution. Okay. So I have to calculate this M3 value, I need to calculate. So let me go on writing the terms, keep M3 as it is, and volume, third volume of the third solution. How the volume of the third solution is obtained? By mixing the first and second. So V3 is equals to V1 plus V2. What is the V1? 480 plus what is V2? 250. Okay. And M1 means 1.5, it is first solution. Its V1 value is 480. Okay, plus M2 means 1.2 into its volume is 250. Are you getting what I am saying? See here, I need to calculate the molarity of the third solution. We have the relationship that M3V3 is equals to M1V1 plus M2V2. As these two solutions are mixing with each other to form this one, third solution. And the question is that to find out the molarity of the third solution, how the volume of the third solution is obtained? By mixing the volume of the first and second solution. So it is V3 is equals to V1 plus V2. So M3 is equals to, this is 1.5480 plus 1.2 into 250, okay, divided by 480 plus 250. So when you calculate this, when you simplify this, you are going to get nearly around 3.97 molar, 3.97 0.97 molar. Okay, so this is the
answer,
3.97 molar. See here, two solutions are mixed, and the solution one, this one is the V1 and this one is the M1, and here it is V2 and here it is M2. So, we have the formula M3 V3 is equals to M1 V1 plus M2 V2. I need to calculate M3. So, I have taken the V3 as the combination of the V1 and V2. So, here M3, if you separate out the term, you are going to get 1.397 molar is the molarity of the mix, that is the resultant solution, that is final mixture. Okay. So, this is how we can explain the molarity of the final mixture, clear. So, next, volume of the CO2 obtained at STP by complete decomposition of 9.85 gram of the BaCO3 is. So, the question is that how much volume of the CO2 is obtained at the STP by complete decomposition of the BaCO3. So, let me tell you, complete decomposition means the reaction will be BaCO3, barium carbonate, which decomposes and it will going to give barium oxide plus carbon dioxide. Barium oxide plus carbon dioxide. So, here, okay. So, we need to calculate the volume of the CO2 obtained. So, there is a one condition that at STP, the question is that at STP they have given, this is the clue. And see here, BaCO3, just calculate the atomic mass of this one, BaCO3. They have given 137 plus carbon 12 plus 48. Okay. So, if you calculate this one, this is this much gram. Okay. This much gram of the BaCO3 will going to give the volume at STP is 22.4 liters. 22.4 liters. Okay. See here, if you calculate 197 gram of BaCO3, 197 gram of BaCO3 will going to give us 22.4 liter volume of, okay. And the question is that 9.85 gram of BaCO3, how much volume it will going to get? 9.85 gram of BaCO3, how much it will going to give us. Okay. So, if I take this one as x, so here 22.4 into 9.85 divided by 197 So, if you calculate this one, you are going to get, that is 1.12 liter. See here, the question is that the volume of the CO2 obtained at STP by complete decomposition of 9.85 gram. It means if I am going to decompose 9.85 gram of BaCO3, during that time the released CO2, how much volume will be obtained by this CO2? That is the question. So, by looking into the reaction we have to write, that is BaCO3 after decomposition it will going to give us BaO, that is barium oxide and carbon dioxide. So, here, if I calculate the molar mass of the BaCO3, it will be around 197 gram. There is a one clue that STP. So, 197 gram will going to, at STP will going to give us 22.4 liters of the CO2. That gas is released, that is the volume. And then the question is that if 9.85 be a CO3, so by looking this, we can able to calculate the volume of the released CO2, that 22.4 into 9.85 divided by 197. So it will be at around 1.12 liters. So here the choice is option D, 1.12 liters. Next, 1.2 gram of the magnesium will produce MgO. It means we are burning 1.2 gram of the magnesium. The question is that it will going to produce the magnesium oxide equals to how much gram? Equals to how much gram? So let me write the reaction first. Mg, when it is reacts with oxygen, there is a formation of the MgO. There is a formation of the MgO. So in order to balance this, I will make. So now it is a correct equation. Mg, when it is burnt in presence of oxygen, it will going to give us magnesium oxide. It will going to give us magnesium oxide. So the question is that if I burnt 1.2 gram of the Mg, how much MgO is produced? So first, see, look at this. 2 Mg, it means 2 grams of the Mg, if I take the atomic mass 2 into 24, 48 gram, okay. So 48 gram of the magnesium, when it is burnt in presence of oxygen, how much MgO is produced? 2 into Mg is 24 plus 16, okay. It will be around 80 gram, okay. 48 gram of the Mg, 48 gram of the magnesium will going to produce 80 gram of the magnesium oxide. 48 gram of Mg produce 80 gram of MgO, okay. The question is that suppose 1.2 gram of the Mg, if it is burnt, how much MgO? That is 1.2 gram of Mg. How much it will going to produce? How much it will going to produce? So simple, let me take this one as X is equals to 80 into 1.2 divided by 48. That is 80. Why it is? Because 48 gram will going to produce 80 gram of MgO. I need to calculate for 1.2. It will be 80 into 1.2 divided by 48. If you calculate this, you are going to get nearly around 2 gram. You are going to get 2 gram. Here the option is C. See, first you have to write the equation. Then only you can able to solve the that problem. How the Mg will going to produce MgO means that is by burning the magnesium with oxygen. Okay, when the magnesium burns in presence of oxygen, we are going to get magnesium oxide, and that is 48 gram of the Mg. And even it is very important to know that write the correct equation, that must be chemically balanced. So 48 gram will going to give us 80 gram of MgO, means the question is to find out how much 1.2 Mg will going to produce the MgO. So simple it is, as according to our ratio problems, we can able to find the value of the MgO, which is formed when 1.2 gram of Mg is burnt. That is, the answer is 2 gram. So like this, we can able to solve the different types of the problems. Okay, we'll continue in our next class.